This video will introduce you to the Crosstab Query in NVivo. The Crosstab Query is a little bit like the matrix coding query in that it lets you cross-tabulate different variables and codes. However, the Crosstab Query enables you to cross-tabulate four dimensions of data. It is also generally faster at performing than the matrix coding query. While the matrix coding query allowed you to bring in almost any of the items in NVivo, a Crosstab Query has a much more limited scope. You can do your own Crosstab Query by going to the Explore ribbon, selecting the Queries option, and then choosing Crosstab. In Detail View, the Crosstab Query criteria will open. First, you need to select whether you're going to Crosstab codes against attributes or cases. Generally speaking, this case option is only useful if you're exporting data into another program, such as SPSS for surveys. So let's leave this at attributes. Next, I need to choose where I'm searching in. I can leave this at all files and externals to work across the entire project, or I can click selected items to choose a particular file, code, or other asset. This time I'm going to bring in a code and explore real estate development and choose OK. I'm then going to bring in some codes, and I'm going to use those attitude or sentiment codes we've looked at in previous videos. To do this, I click on plus underneath codes. In the codes folder, I open attitude and select mixed, negative, neutral, and positive. Just as before, the order of these needs adjusting using the arrows until they make sense. So far, we've specified two dimensions of data. We're searching in the real estate development code, and we're cross-tabulating this against the positive, mixed, negative, and neutral attitude codes. I now need to choose a classification. I'm going to leave this at person to look at the person cases, and then I can choose which attributes I wish to explore this by. I'm going to look at community, and I'm going to look at age group. I'm now ready to run the query. You can see this table is very expansive and actually quite difficult to read. If you look in the contextual ribbon for crosstabs, you'll see there's the option to transpose this data. So I'm going to click on this button and it will flip my table around and make it easier for me to read. Just as with the matrix coding query, I can also use cell shading to make this easier to read. This is allowing me to explore positive, mixed, negative, and neutral attitude about real estate development across all cases classified as person. I'm also further exploring this by the attribute values for community and age group. Let's look at how we'd read this table in a bit more detail. If you see where it says community equals straights, that number 8 indicates that 8 cases match that criteria. So there are a total of 8 people with the attribute straights. If we look down the age group columns, you'll can see there's a few of those age groups with 0. That means there were no participants in those age categories. It's therefore unsurprising that there are 0 people expressing any of these sentiments for those particular rows. If we look at age groups 50 to 59 and 60 to 69, we can see there's 3 people in each of those. And looking at both the positive and the negative sentiment, there's 3 in each of those as well. This means that 100% of people from the straights community in those age groups expressed positive and negative attitude about real estate development. Again, this shows how we have to be careful when interpreting those numbers. While there are some darker shades of green further down the table, in some instances those numbers are still lower than the total number of people matching that criteria. Of course, I've not got enough participants across all of these age groups to do anything statistical or make any numerical assertions, but this is still a useful way for me to explore my data. You'll see, just as with the matrix coding query, I can double click on one of these cells, for example, exploring the positive sentiment from residents aged 60 to 69 in Harkers Island when talking about real estate development by double clicking here. And all of the relevant text is displayed. I can switch back to the query and explore another area, for example, the negative sentiment from people aged 50 to 59 from Marshallberg when discussing real estate development. Hopefully this is a really good demonstration of how powerful this query is. Even if you're not here for the numbers, it's a really good way for you to dive straight in to look at the text for very specific sets of variables. You'll see at the moment this table is bringing in cases coded, that is the total number of cases matching the criteria. We also have the option to switch to coding references and coding presence to further explore this detail. On the right hand side, you also have the chart tab, but you'll find that there's too much data here to be charted, so we'd have to strip this query down a little bit to visualise it. Let's look at another crosstab query for an example of this. I've looked at four of the economy codes, and I'm cross-tabulating them against the person case classification, and I've selected the generations down east and gender attributes. Now that the query's run, you'll see I can go to the chart tab here and view a chart for the findings of this particular query. I can use the chart ribbon at the top of the screen to view and alternate between the different chart styles. As with any visualization in NVivo, I can right click and export these results.